Hi, I'm John Mulligan with Global Energy News. Today, we're going to be testing one of the H2 Global water-based fuel systems. In this box here, I have the dry electronics, and in this box here, we have the water fuel mixture. This unit here, we are controlling the airflow manually. We are working on an automated system, but at the moment we're using the manual airflow controller here. And this opens and allows more air in, or we can allow less air in and turn it down. We're using an endoscopic camera to show the dry box electronics. As you can see, the gas tank has been removed from this engine. We're going to take 5 milliliters of gasoline and inject it into this fuel line here and see how long the engine runs. We are drawing 5 milliliters of gasoline. Now we're going to start the engine and see how long it runs. We're going to start it again to see if there's any gas left in the bowl. Now, this is ordinary drinking water, and I'm going to pour 450 milliliters into this jug. I'm now going to pour it into our unit. And as I did before, I'm going to draw 5 milliliters of gasoline. And inject it into the same chamber I put the water in. And that's 5 mil of gasoline added to the water. At this point, we've just added the water and the 5 milliliters of gasoline into the chamber. I'm going to turn on the power for the water fuel system that is going to provide the power to change the water's molecular structure. This unit here uses 282 milliamps at 24 volts. We have another system which uses less power, that's 170 milliamps at 24 volts. Now the power's at 282 to 283 milliamps, I'm going to start the engine. Now to begin with, the choke is in a regular position, which will be open during the run about halfway, and then later on it will be fully open. This is the fuel shutoff valve, which will be off during the run while we're on our water system. I'm going to start her now.